Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss about a new topic in neurology, Down syndrome. In the introduction, Down syndrome is a genetic disorder that causes a lifelong intellectual disability, developmental delays, and other problems. You have to understand that it is a genetic disorder. I did not mean it is a inherited or what we call as inherited disorder. It's a genetic disorder. Only a few percentage is only inheritance. So Down syndrome is a genetic disorder that causes a lifelong intellectual disability. We don't use the term mental retardation nowadays. So the major problem is intellectual disability. Second would be developmental delays and various other problems, which we will discuss in detail. Down syndrome varies in severity, so developmental problems range from moderate to serious. We usually don't find, very rarely do we find children Down syndrome children with Down syndrome to be having a mild problem. Most of the time they have moderate problems and equally serious problems. Down syndrome is the most common genetic cause of the leading to learning disabilities in children. Increased understanding of Down syndrome and early interventions make a big difference in the lives of both children and adults with Down syndrome. Down syndrome is not contagious. Please understand, if you be near to a child with Down syndrome, it is not going to be a contagious disease. It is not a disease at all. It is a syndrome and cannot be cured by medicine or surgery. There is no cure till date through medicine or surgery what you can help the child with Down syndrome. So you can cure with medicine the other problems or associated complications can be corrected through surgery. But Down syndrome as such cannot be cured by a medicine or surgery. Causes. Human cells normally contain 23 pairs of chromosomes. We all know that. One chromosome in each pair comes from the father, the other from the mother. That's, we know that 22 pairs of autosomes and one pair of sex chromosomes. So the equally, it is shared equally from the father and the mother. Down syndrome results when one of three types of abnormal subdivision involving the chromosome 21. So usually the problem related to the Down syndrome is happening in the chromosome number 21. The chromosome number 21 should be a pair, which is an autosome. When I am saying 21, it is an autosome. So here the autosome should have two copies or what you call as pair. So two numbers of chromosomes should be, autosomes should be there in the chain of the chromosome. But here there is an abnormality in the cell division leading to three types of division. Three, that's why we call it as trisomy. All three cells, here it should be two cells, leading to three cell division. Abnormal result in extra genetic material from chromosome 21. There is going to be an extra material in the 21st pair of chromosome. So you, naturally you should have two cells, here you will have three, which is responsible for the characteristic features and developmental problems of Down syndrome. So this extra genetic material which is in the 21st chromosome is leading to all the characteristic clinical features and the developmental problems faced by the children with Down syndrome. The three genetic variation that can cause Down syndromes are, in the genetic variation, according to the genetic variation, there is no classification of Down syndrome. Here it is a three genetic variation. So don't think that Down syndrome is classified like this. It's not like that. It is only the genetic variations. According to the genetic variations, can cause Down syndrome include three, in a three way. One is trisomy 21. Second is mosaic Down syndrome. Third is translocation Down syndrome. So continuing in the causes, most of the time Down syndrome isn't inherited. I already told you it's genetic, it's not inherited. It's caused by a mistake in cell division during the development of the egg. During the conception, when the ova and the sperm fertilizes and forms a conception, and then the embryo is formed. Here, usually it's a cell division mistake from the development of the egg, or either sperm or embryo. It can be the cell mistake, divisional mistake of the cell of the ova, either the ova or the sperm or the embryo. In three areas, it can be from the mother's ova or the father's sperm or the embryo, which is conceived first, conceived a young form of the life. Translocation Down syndrome is the only form of disorder that can be passed from parent to child. The only inherited Down syndrome is only the translocation Down syndrome, which is usually passed from the parent to the child. However, only 4% of the children with Down syndrome have translocation Down syndrome. That means that only 4% of the total population of the Down syndrome, 4% is inheritance, that is from the parents, passed from the parent to the child. Otherwise, 96% of the children, it happens during a mistake in the cell division in egg, that is the ova or sperm or embryo. And only about half of these children inherited it from one of their parents. So in out of 4%, then we have translocation Down syndrome. Only half of them in that from one of their parents. So half of them may have it in the 4%, the 2% may be from half of any one of their parents. So now we going into detail of the types of syndrome due to genetic variations. The maximum number of patients belong to 95% belong to the first group, that is called as trisomy 21. Three chromosome in 21st pair, we usually should be two. Here we have three chromosomes in every cell, that is three chromosomes 21 in every cell. Translocation 3 to 5%, already we told you that's actually 4%. 3 to 5 extra part of the chromosome 21 attaches to another chromosome in every cell. Extra part of the chromosome 21 attaches to another chromosome in every cell. In mosaic, it is 1 to 2%. Mixture of cells. Here actually mosaic means the mosaic tiles, right? It is a mixture of the stones which are used. So here it is a mixture of cells. Here the abnormal and normal, it's a mixture of normal and abnormal cells. Mixture of cells, that's why we call it. It is very rarely seen, only 1% to 2% children belong to this group. Mixture of cells, some with an extra chromosome 21, others with just 2. So now going to detail, trisomy 21, more than 90% or 94% of the time, Down syndrome is caused by trisomy 21. A child with trisomy 21 has 3 copies of chromosome 21. Instead of a usual 2 copies, that he or she will have 3 copies of chromosome in the 21st chromosome. This form of Down syndrome is caused by abnormal cell division during the development of sperm cell or the egg cell. Either the sperm cell or the egg cell means ova. In mosaic, already I told you, it is a rare form of Down syndrome, children having some cells with an extra copy of 21 cell. But here, it's almost same like the trisomy 21, but the only thing is, it's a mosaic of normal and it's a mixture of normal and abnormal cells caused by abnormal cell division after the fertilization. It is happening after the fertilization, and that is a two difference. One is mosaic is the Down syndrome. Mistake happens in the cell division, abnormal cell division after fertilization, and most of the time it is a mixture of normal and abnormal cells. That's why it is called as mosaic Down syndrome. In the third one is a translocation Down syndrome. 3 to 4% of all cases of trisomy 21 are due to Robertsonian translocation. So it's called as Robertsonian translocation. In this case, two breaks occur in separate chromosomes, usually the 14th and the 21st chromosome. So here the only difference is it happens also in the, it can happen in the translocation, that is Robertsonian translocation Down syndrome. It can also happen in the 14th pair of the chromosome along with the 21st chromosome. There is a derangement of the genetic material so that some of the 14th chromosome is replaced by the extra. So there is some derangement in the 14th. There it will be replaced by the extra 21st chromosome. That's why translocation of genetic material from 21st extra, and it is translocating to the 14th chromosome where there is some derangement. So this movement of the chromosome material, genetic material from the 21st to the 14th is called as a translocation Down syndrome. The extra 21st chromosome is attached to or translocated on the another chromosome, usually on chromosome 14, 21 or 22. Translocations resulting in trisomy 21 may be inherited. So it is important to check the chromosome of the parents in these cases to see if either may be a carrier. So that means that if a child is understood to be a translocation Down syndrome, then the medical personnel have to be very cautious. Why? Because that next sibling also can have maybe a child with Down syndrome. So here it is inheritance. The other area, other classifications, it is purely genetic, and the mistake is in the cell division. Here it is translocation, or the extra chromosome is locating, relocating from one place to another number. So what are the risk factors? Some parents have a higher, greater risk of having a baby with Down syndrome. We don't, the cause is not definite. So the medical scientists are talking about some of the risk factors which may lead to. We have seen that these risk factors are common with parents whom they get having Down syndrome child. So the risk factors include advancing maternal age. A woman's chance of giving birth to a child with Down syndrome increases with age, because older ova, the older egg of the woman, have a greater risk of improper chromosome division. We already know that the improper or mistake in the cell division, chromosome division, is happening, and this is aggravated when the age of the mother is increasing. Why? Because when the age of the mother increases, the age of her ovaries or the ova, the egg, also increasing. This will increase the risk factor for chances of Down syndrome. By age 35, a woman's risk of conceiving a child with Down syndrome is 1 in 400. By age 45, it is 1 in 35. So that means a lady who is trying to conceive after the age of 45, 1 in 35. Every 35 ladies who are above the age of 45 conceiving, one child becomes a Down syndrome. So this has to be education. This education has to be given to the society. However, most children with Down syndrome are actually born to women under the age of 35. Even though 45, above 45 age group having the largest risk, but most of the time the children's born are the mother's age are below 35, because younger women have far more babies. Having had one child with Down syndrome, typically a woman who has one child with Down syndrome has about 1% of chance of again having another children. Why? Because it should be a translocation type. We already discussed that translocation type is an inherited type. So in that 2%, 1%, if it is from the mother, if it is from one parent, I already told you. So here in this case, in the 2%, 1% is from the mother. So in the translocation type, 1%, if it is from the mother, is a carrier. So there is a definite chance that again the next child may be also a sibling, may also develop Down syndrome. So the being carriers of genetic translocation for Down syndrome, both men as well as women can pass the genetic translocation for Down syndrome on to their children. So equal chances of mother or father being a carrier in case of Robertsonian translocation Down syndrome. So in that percentage, we have to see that only 1% of the total population are, you know, due to inheritance. So inheritance basically happen into 2% to 3% of translocation Robertson in Down syndrome, out of which higher inheritance possibility is in 1% of total population of Down syndrome children.